It's tree planting time here in Central Texas, and we're now joined by Paul Johnson from Texas A&M, and he is their tree guy with the Forest Service. Yes. And we are so excited that you came here to give us some great tips about taking care of the biggest investments in our gardens.
Absolutely. Yeah. They're so important to us.
Right. Trees are a big deal, pun intended. Mm-hmm. They are the biggest plants we use in our gardens. Yes. And there are lots of considerations for people out there in terms of what they should be thinking about in terms of tree care, right?
Absolutely. From the time that you decide that you want to plant a tree, so you need to figure out where you want to put it, what the conditions are like there, so you can find a tree that will grow well there.
Right.
We've been talking about right tree, right place for decades,
mm-hmm.
and yet we regularly see somebody fell in love with a tree and decided to try to shoehorn it in somewhere
right.
that it didn't really belong.
Well, and that's really critically important. And what are some of the most common mistakes people make when they misplace a tree?
I think the biggest thing is not paying attention to size.
Mm-hmm.
When that little 5-gallon tree is so cute and it's only about your height,
yeah.
and you can put it right next to the house or you put it right next to the driveway, mm-hmm. and then in just a few years, as it starts to grow and develop, it starts interfering with either you or the house. And it can
power
it can
lines.
Cause power lines, absolutely.
Yeah.
It can cause some real problems.
Yeah, neighbor's house, you name it, the trees can do it.
Yes.
But, you know, so appropriate scale. The good news here really is that in terms of varieties, there are plants that fill every niche,
yes.
from small trees to towering giants, so.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
It's really just incumbent upon us
mm-hmm.
to realize what the needs of the plant that we're looking at are.
Right.
I do a couple of different ways of teaching people, but it's all about doing just a little bit of research and mm-hmm. saying, oh, well, I love how this tree looks. What's it going to look like at maturity? If it's going to be 50 feet wide, mm-hmm. you probably want to try to put it at least 20, 25 feet away from anything like a house or a power line, because ultimately it's going to get to be that 50 feet wide.
Okay, so I mentioned that it's tree planting time. Fall is the time we encourage people
mm-hmm.
to get out there and choose these different varieties. Let's give them a couple of quick tips about planting. I like to recommend that people start small.
Oh, I absolutely. The process of producing a tree in a container is challenging.
Mm-hmm.
So the larger the container that you're working with, the more small containers it's been in.
Mm-hmm.
And each time that it's moved from one to another, if it's not handled the right way, you can have some real ticking time bombs in that root system.
Right, right. So start small. 5-gallon plant, I think, is
yeah.
ideal.
I think it's a great size.
You know, this is the time of year. Don't plant them too deep. That's a critical thing. That's one of the most common mistakes, isn't it?
Absolutely. Really, it's key to have that root flare.
Mm-hmm.
And really, from where it flares from the trunk into the root should be visible after you plant it.
Mm-hmm.
And often it's buried in the container.
Right.
So you might even have to dig down a little ways to figure out where that root flare
mm-hmm.
is and then make sure that that's visible even after you've mulched the tree.
Okay. Well, everybody knows we've been lecturing them on taking care of the trees after they're in the ground, of watering consistently and deeply for the first couple of years, really, to get them on
upon their weather, absolutely.
Right. But, you know, trees, there's all sorts of things that can happen with a tree. And this year, the weather that we've experienced has caused some strange behavior on trees, and a lot of people are very anxious about this. For example, I'm getting a lot of calls on my radio show
mm-hmm.
of people saying, I'm seeing oak trees completely drop all their, you know, the live oaks are dropping all their leaves right now. Are they dying? Do we have oak wilt? And I'm like, I think they're confused.
Absolutely. It's amazing. This year it was so wet in the
mm-hmm.
spring. And then we went through something that we've now started calling a flash drought.
Yeah, right.
4 years ago, nobody was using that term.
Yeah.
But this is the second year in a row that it's gone from wet to super hot and dry. So the trees go dormant,
mm-hmm.
just like they go dormant during the winter.
Mm-hmm.
And then it cools off a little bit. The rain starts to come. They wake back up. And
right.
so they have been confused. And many of them think that it is spring.
Yeah. So we're seeing trees bloom. We're
mm-hmm.
seeing fruit production and leaf drop and new leaves as well. So
yes.
it's a real combination. In terms of other kinds of things on the horizon, we were just talking about a critter that's moving into Texas.
Yes.
And this is a big concern for the Forest Service. It's the emerald ash borer.
Yes.
Now, when I first heard of this, I thought, oh, good, those Arizona ash are finally going to be gone. But There are broader concerns here.
There are broader concerns because emerald ash borer affects every North American species of ash that they've run into. Mm-hmm. It's an imported critter from Asia, showed up in the Detroit area in 2002, and has proceeded to march across the country. It's now in 27 or 28 states, and it just showed up in Texas earlier this year.
Now, the scale of the damage here is, you were telling me, this could be pretty intense.
This will be very intense. It has been landscape changing in the Northeast.
Mm-hmm.
Generally across Texas, we're only looking at somewhere between 2 to 10% of our urban forests are ash trees. But there are some neighborhoods that it's 70 to 80%. And when you lose all of those, you lose all of the benefits that come with the trees.
Is there any prevention?
There's no prevention. There is some protection. So if you have a tree that you particularly love, that you're willing to invest in, you can do some insecticide injections into the trunk of the tree.
Okay.
And there are even some organic options that you can inject. It does wound the tree, but it is a way to be a very specific, only treating that tree for that pest, and does give a year or two of protection, and then you have to repeat.
Okay, well, that sounds pretty intense in terms of treatment, but we'll keep our fingers crossed that they bypass Central Texas.
Yes, we can hope, but it's okay. All the way over into the Boulder area in Colorado, now in Nebraska, and it's all over.
All right, well, bad news on that front, but let's turn to some more tips for homeowners. A lot of people, you know, when you drive through a lot of neighborhoods and you see young trees or even established trees, what you always seem to see around the base of it are planting beds.
Yes.
And some people are concerned, especially with the young trees, should they create a planting bed around them and fill them with things like annuals or shade-loving plants?
Ideally, you just have a nice mulched area around your tree.
Okay.
One of the challenges with putting plants around the base of the tree is you have to water those plants.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're often concentrating water right around the trunk of the tree, which isn't the best place to water a tree.
Mm-hmm.
You can increase some fungal disease issues if you keep that root crown too wet.
Right.
If you're going to do it, a perennial is a much better choice than an annual, because you also get some root disturbance every time that you should go digging in there in order to plant the annuals. And around here, you're looking at two or three seasons of annuals that you're generally looking at. So if you want to put in something that's not going to be quite so intensively managed, it's okay. But still, mulch is probably the best. We spend a lot of time making our plants drought susceptible. We don't water them irregularly and deeply. We want that irrigation system to go off 15 minutes every afternoon, no matter what the rules say. And therefore, you only wet the soil a little ways.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you don't even get down to where the roots of the tree are. So
exactly.
You can have a great, beautiful green lawn and a tree that's dying of drought.
Well, we could spend the rest of the afternoon talking about all these great topics, Paul, but thank you so much for coming over to be a part of the program. And thank you also for helping us encourage folks out there to plant trees this time of year. So it's been a pleasure meeting you.
Nice to meet you, too.
All right. And coming up next is our friend Daphne.